This is MJ with MinIO. Welcome back to the Kubernetes overview portion of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. Let's jump into the next topic.
So I mentioned earlier storage classes. Storage classes are the superset of persistent volumes, and a storage class is essentially pools of data storage in your cluster. This could be, you know, locals using something like DirectPV, or it could be some sort of network attached storage that you're presenting to your nodes in your cluster. But essentially, they are a way to define different pools of storage for different use cases. So it provides a way for administrators to describe the classes of storage, and the different classes might map to, in your definition, quality of service level. So maybe you have some attached storage is less reliable than others, and maybe you want to clearly define that and make sure that that is known to the end user. So you would give it some descriptive name like archive only or something like that. There's also different speeds of the underlying storage. So say you have some SSDs and some NVMEs, that's very expensive, but also very fast. And so you will want to limit the use of that expensive and fast storage because it's usually smaller in capacity and costs more money. Whereas you might also define something slower like rotating disks or hard drives, where the storage capacity is much higher, but is also the throughput is much lower. Maybe you'll only use that for archival or workloads do not require high input output. So you can define these different storage classes and then assign your workloads accordingly. So maybe you'd point your database that needs a lot of throughput to your very fast storage class, which has SSDs. But then you also might say that this is our archive storage bucket in the MinIO instance, and we're just keeping backups and archive data here. That doesn't need to be fast, that's rarely accessed. So we're going to point that at our much larger, but slower hard drive based storage class for that. Let's go take a look at the demo for this. So here we are in a demo, and you can see that if I type kget sc, there is a single storage class called local path defined here. And the volume bind mounting, that's what I was talking about earlier, why it was waiting instead of bound already, is it's waiting for a consumer, something to actually consume that storage. And there's lots of other definitions here that we won't get into around how this works in terms of configuring the underlying storage classes to suit your needs. There's lots of other configuration items, but you'll need to dive into that on your own. So what we're going to take a look at is our storage class that we're going to create. So what we're going to do is define a new storage class that is for our SSDs on this host. And so we're saying the kind is storage class, the metadata is local path SSD, and then we're just calling the provisioner that happens to be installed. Again, because Kubernetes is pluggable, you can have multiple different types of provisioners installed. So you could have a local path, you could have direct PV, you could have some sort of NFS or network-based provisioner in here, and those all have their own parameters for how they operate. But we'll go ahead and apply this, and we'll be able to see that there's a new storage class created. And so now you can see there's a local path SSD storage class created. And if we do get sc, now there are two separate ones defined. So note that one is marked as default. So if you do not define the storage class that you want this to go to, your workload to go to, it's going to automatically go to this one. So you'll need to be very specific in your manifest and your definitions of what you're deploying, which storage classes should attach to. And you want to make sure that if this is a database or something that requires faster speeds, that you are assigning it to the proper storage class. In this case, it would be SSD, so that it gets the throughput that it needs.
Thanks for joining us for this Kubernetes overview topic as part of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. We look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks and have a good one.